When I was 14, I got diagnosed with depression, and it seemed to only get worse over years. But in the last couple of years, I developed anxiety, as well as sort of some side effects of anxiety, which is hypervigilance. It's not paranoia or post-traumatic stress disorder. It's a type of anxiety that sort of heightens your vigilance, I suppose. I think all these years of dealing with depression, I was able to sort of understand it and learn to cope with it. The anxiety's new. That's a strange one. Admittedly, even I kind of looked at it and was like, anxiety, like, what do you mean you get scared when you get on the bus? But now that I'm experiencing it, it's terrifying. Dealing with these things for so long, it sucks, but at the same time, you sort of build a resilience. Sticking to a regime of medication's been really great for me. I don't want somebody going to their doctor to talk about something and that doctor just prescribing them something and being like, there we go, problem solved. Because medication doesn't solve your problems, you know. It makes them easier. By all means, it makes it easier, but I think you still need to work on things that you can do for yourself to get better. And therapy was a big one for me. I think as a Pasifika male, there is a lot of pressure to be tough and be strong. And speaking from my own personal experience, that yeah, there's a lot of people that don't understand what it is and they think that it's just weakness. From discussions I've had with older people about how mental illness was sort of viewed back in the day, back in the islands, it kind of seemed like you were either normal or you were like crazy. And I think some of those sort of ideologies around stigma was passed on, and it still sort of sits in our community. But I think that stigma is slowly changing. You know, when I speak about it publicly, I get friends of mine that call and be like, hey, be careful, people might use this against you. You know, you're showing some weakness. And like, I'm aware that I'm being vulnerable, but I don't think it's weakness. I've always thought that if I was ever to become or have a platform of influence, it would be my responsibility to be honest. We should use it for some good. And I think being honest with people who are listening and viewing our content, actually know that we're real people and that we understand, especially in our Pasifika community. But originally when we came out with talking about my mental illness, I did want to sort of push away that stigma by talking about mental illness very casually, that they're not alone, that it can affect anybody. But I want people to know that there's plenty of help out there. It's affordable, it's easily accessible. Sometimes the hardest part about it is just admitting that you have the problem.